everyone, this is Jimmy from Biolight. Today we'll be introducing our brand new CMS BioVision. As you can see, we have already connected 7 patients in the system. And the operating system is Windows 7, Windows 10 with server of 32 bits or 64 bits. And the recommended configuration is CPU Intel i7, 16GB. BioVision supporting brand new P series patient monitor, S series patient monitor, and M series, and our A series and Q series. And the communication mode is including wired and Wi-Fi. And the number of monitoring devices is up to 64 bits being monitored at the same time. And screen support 1 screen, dual screen, 3 screen, and either 4 screen. Depends on the screen size and how many patients that we need to put it into the system. And we have our P15, which is the brand new P-series patient monitor. And also we have our P18, and also S-series patient monitor. And including our P1 transport monitor. And another S-series. And also M-series. M10 and M12. When we go to the BioVision interface, on the left corner, you'll be able to see the menu settings. And we can click on to the system settings. The first is general, and we can customize the volumes. And also the second option is display. And once we key in the passcode, we'll be able to customize all the parameter colors. And if you want to change the display layout, then we can select here. And we can customize alarms. And the third option, we can change the volumes. And we can change device management. Depends on the sequence that you want to arrange. Management, we can choose the information that we want. And we can change the patient group, depends on the nurse's needs. We can change the group name. Alright, so I can change the patient group. We have review page, and we can set up the review train settings. And we can set up the network, and we can set up printer. And we can change language in the settings. Customize modules. The first one is ECG standard, depends on which ECG standard we use, either AHA or either IEC. And we can change system time. And this is factory maintenance. And when we go to the main page, on the interface, we will be able to see the notifications over here. Once we click onto it, we will be able to see the physiological alarms and technical alarms. We use mouse to double click onto the first patient. We will be able to go to this Viewbed page, and we can expand ECG waveforms, and also we can change different displays. And the first is alarm settings. Customize each and every of the parameters, alarm limits, alarm level, just on one page. And also we can choose different screen displays. I can choose from normal screen, choose from Minitrends, OxyCRG. And when we choose ECG screen, we'll be able to see all 12 leads on the screen. We'll include lead 1, 2, 3, AVL, AVR, AVF, and V1 to V6. And also we can freeze the waveform by clicking onto this icon. And once we freeze the waveform, we will be able to print out if we have a printer connected to CMS. Okay, once we clip, the printer will print out the frame. Also from the CMS, we will be able to remotely put the patient monitor into standby mode. Once we click standby, the system will prompt us a notification. Are you sure you want to go to standby? Then we click OK. And the respective monitor will be going to standby mode. And also we can resume monitoring. After we monitor patient's ECG for a period of time, we will be able to see ECG 24 hours summary page. Over here, we can open full disclosure. Can support up to 240 hours of full disclosure, 240 hours of trends, and for NIPP review, it support up to 1,000 NIPP measurement results. And for cardiac output, it support up to 720 cardiac output measurement results. In this full disclosure page, we will be able to open all those waveforms storage. And for display page, we'll be able to support up to 3 waveforms being displayed at the same time. And if there is abnormality detected during this period of time, if we want to focus on this part of the ECG, we can click detail and we can open up the detailed page for us to analyze the ECGs. And also we have a selection button here. Once we click, we'll be able to select a period of ECG waveform and print it out. Okay, once we finish the selection, we can click on the print button. We'll click on the print. And it will print out from the printer that connected. As you can see, this is the duration that we selected. And we can customize the quick keys. We click onto the quick keys. As we can see, we have several default settings here. And if we want to choose some of the quick keys that we want to put it onto the menu bar, we can choose the location. Then we choose, for example, an NIPP measurement. For example, when I go to night mode, okay, so I can put it here. And after that, I close. And I will be able to see an NIPP measurement and night mode over here.